Let f of x equal negative 8 sine of cosine x. So this one's a tad bit tricky because the input for one trig function is some other trig function. And it looks like a mess, but just remember your properties here. So we have a function evaluated at some other function. So that other function is an inside function, which I can call u of x. So u of x equals cosine x. Now, f of x looks like negative 8 sine of u, which is a lot nicer than what we had originally. So that the derivative of f, well, I can do this. I know how to do a chain rule. So this is negative 8. We take the derivative of the outside function. So the derivative of sine is cosine. We leave the inside function alone and then multiply by the derivative of the inside function. So this is kind of charting what I need to actually do when I find the derivative. So let's see how it pans out. So we have the negative 8 cosine of u, and u is cosine x, which is going to look a little strange, but that's a perfectly fine way of thinking about this. It's cosine evaluated at cosine again. And you can do that. There's no problem there. You can type in cosine of, I don't know, am I in radians or, I guess it doesn't matter, I'll just put in one. But you can do that. The calculator will take the cosine of the value one, whatever that answer is, plug it into cosine again, and it'll give you an answer. Like that's a perfectly valid thing, even though it looks strange. But then we multiply this by the derivative of the inside function, so the derivative of cosine. The derivative of cosine is negative sine. So to simplify here, I will cancel out the negatives and make that a positive 8 sine x cosine of cosine x. And when you type that into your answer box, you will need to make these functions, which means you need to just put parentheses around those x's there. But that right there, that is a perfectly valid answer, and you're all set.